In today's video, you're gonna learn how two friends of ours went from becoming freelancers to starting and owning their own design company. You don't wanna miss this one. Hey everybody, it's Nick here again from Greyscalegorilla, giving you the tools, training, and tutorials to help make you a better motion designer. Now, today we have a great presentation from HalfRez, but before we get there, I wanted to make sure that you're subscribed to our YouTube channel, where we have plenty more videos just like this, including tutorials, interviews, and podcasts, all designed to really help you step your game up. Now, speaking of stepping your game up, we also just launched our training page with hundreds of hours of Cinema 4D and motion design training waiting for you to really watch and learn from. So if you're interested in that, I'm gonna link it up down below and also right here on YouTube. All right, with that, let's get into today's video. Today's video was recorded during HalfRez 2016 when we had our friends Nick and Erik from Run Kick Shout hop up on stage and share their journey from going from freelancers to now owning their own studio. They talk about pitfalls, things that worked, things that didn't, and really answer a lot of the questions that we get from you guys wondering more about the business side of this industry. So please help me welcome to the HalfRez stage, Nick Hopkins and Erik Jensen from Run, Kick, Shout. These next two gentlemen, I have had the pleasure of being friends with for over 10 years now. They've both been incredible artists in the community and incredible people and friends. I've seen them grow from 5-second project contributors to full-time animators, freelancers, and this year starting their very own design studio. Give it up for that, man. Starting your own studio. That's amazing. They've made incredible work for AT&T, Toys R Us, Motorola, Toyota, and more. They're here to share their story on how they built their studio and some of the challenges they've had along the way. Please help me welcome Erik Jensen and Nick Hopkins from Run, Kick, Shout. Give it up for them.
Hello?
Hello?
It works.
Hey guys.
Hello.
Ooh, I like that.
Hello, hello. Hey guys, what's up? Yeah.
Hey.
We did it.
Nick is tall. He's very tall.
Me or Nick Campbell?
Oh, Campbell.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. You're tall too.
I thought I was tall, but I guess not.
Not quite as tall. Let me put my beer down.
We're gonna double team it. Yeah, but thanks, guys. Thanks to Chad and Chris before us.
Yeah, the whole GSG team, Jack, all the sponsors. What an event, huh? All right, here we go. So we're going to talk to you guys about starting a studio. I'm going to get used to this mic. Both having been freelancers for a good chunk of time before that. Tomorrow, you're just gonna remember this as the talk before people. So.
Yes, so.
So here we go.
We are Run, Kick, Shout. We've heard Run, Kick, Jump. I've actually heard that tonight. And we actually heard Run, Kick, Scream. Some client actually thought that we were Run, Kick, Scream, like a horror throwback, but.
We like it. I think we're going to go with it.
I think we're Run, Kick, Scream.
Yeah, okay, so we're going to do that.
If you like it.
We're rebranding.
We're a 3D shop. We 3D-centered studio. I've been in C4D since I've started my professional career. We got Erik last year, I think, right?
Yeah, I converted. Yeah, from Max.
He was a Max holdout. Him and Chad.
We got one of you now.
Yeah, so. We just love the 3D process.
Oh, some booze. I like that. I like that. That's good.
Get out of here, you faker. We just love doing 3D stuff. That's what our shop's centered around. Yeah, just the tools. And
we're going to give you a little taste of some of the stuff we've done. And am I all right? All right, cool. So here we go.
Run, kick, jump.
your hands now. Clap your hands now. Clap your hands now. Go ahead and clap your hands now. Clap your hands now. Clap your hands now. Clap your hands now. Go ahead and clap your hands now. Clap. Unreroute the rivers. Let the damned water beat. There's some people down the way that's thirsty, so let the liquid spirit free. The people are thirsty because of man's unnatural hand. Watch what happens when the people catch wind, when the water hit the bank of that hard, dry land. Clap your hands down. Clap your hands down. Clap your hands down. Clap your hands down.
Thanks, guys.
Cool. All right.
That's what we do. We did it. Yeah, thank you. I appreciate that. Seriously.
That's all of it. We're done here.
Go home. We're done.
Yeah.
We're done.
So, full disclosure, we are not experts on starting a business.
Yeah, we're not coming at this from, like, you know, 20 years ago we started this super sweet studio and...
Yeah. Here's the do's and don'ts of that. This is just our experience of what we've gone through in the past year and how we got to that point.
Yeah, we launched Run Kick Shout 6 months ago, so this is just stuff we're going through. So, not a doctor, going through it right now.
These are our own opinions.
That's our disclosure. It's fine.
So, let's go back in time.
History time!
Woo! Nick spent 3 days on this.
I had to convince him to let me do this.
Yeah. It's good. No, it looks good. Yeah.
So much time.
Way too much time.
Yeah, anyways.
No, it looks good.
All right, so we're going to go back a little bit.
Hold on.
If Erik can figure the Mac out. Yeah.
There we go.
All right, here we are. Here's a photo from like back in 2012.
We're not posing. We're hatching a plan.
Yeah, we're totally not drunk. Anyways, at this point, we're both freelancing. I had been full-time a little bit. And we're like...
We're about 4 years into professional life. Nick had just gone freelance about a year before. I was doing most direct-to-client stuff. And we're like, how do we work more together? Like, how do we make that happen?
It wasn't happening by coincidence. We had a ton of sweet personal projects.
Oh, man, they were sweet.
They were the best personal projects you've ever heard of.
Oh, they were sweet.
Didn't happen.
Yeah, you'll never see them.
They haven't happened to this day. But they were the best. Super... inspirational stuff.
Right. So, but we're like, how can we force this? Like, how do we actually work together? How do we make that work?
Yeah.
So, just another slide. Yeah. All right. And
it was really fun, like, finding these pictures, actually. But yeah. So we had to show it. Anyways. Yeah. So anyway, we had this moment where we're like, if it's not going to happen by coincidence, maybe we should just figure out how to force it through. I mean...
Yeah, like, a lot of the jobs were like, single person jobs, like it was just, you know, one of us, and we're like, what if we could just like pitch this as a team? So that was our like light bulb moment. You know, we really like, we got this. Like,
yeah.
Well, like, what's?
We got this. Something's gonna happen.
Those beers paid off.
We're the smartest guys in the world.
Yeah. So, even though we launched this year. This really began back 3 years ago, in 2013. And we were like, why don't we just dip our toes in, see if we can, you know, make this happen.
Let's just try something new, you know?
Yeah, right? Yeah. So it all began with this email that Nick sent me.
So this is an email I got from... So not every job that you get as a freelancer is going to be... it's not going to be, you know, something that... could change into whatever you want it to be. It's
right.
Not.
Yeah, you gotta basically like, you know, play it out. Like, is this something that we could maybe like pitch together or something like that? So Nick, probably you saw the creative. You're like, maybe this is something we can actually do together.
This can be bigger than just me. So let's just pitch ourselves as a team. Like, F it, why not?
Right. So Nick responded to this, and he basically said this, and to focus in a little more on that.
Yeah. So we made the choice to say, I'm not an artist. We're actually a package deal. We're a team. If you look at some of the wording in this first email 3 years ago, we were saying, so if we move forward on this, it would be as a team. And right. because of that, we're going to elevate the creative. We're going to change.
Yeah, like, it's, you're going to be better for it. Yeah, like, this is good for you guys.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
Sorry.
I mean, it should be.
We hoped it would be.
There's no doubt here. But
I think it was also like, you know, there's a little bit of trepidation for us. Like, we're like, this came to Nick. This is, you know, they probably came to Nick because they like Nick's stuff. And then he's introducing both of us. So job could go away. But that's not what happened. They responded with no hesitation at all.
Really surprising, actually, for our first time. Yeah. And they had no questions about the situation.
Yeah, they were just like, cool, let's do this.
So probably the best scenario we could have imagined.
Yeah, and we were feeling pretty good about it. We're like, fuck yeah.
Right.
Sorry.
I don't think this is PC, so.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah. And, you know, we also felt.
Yeah. I still, that still happens from
yeah.
time to time.
When we win jobs, this is what happens to Nick.
No, I'm good. Okay, I think I'm fine.
Yeah, we'll move past that. Sorry. But you know, that really taught us that, like, it's not what you are, it's what you say you are. We're quoting ourselves here as of today. today's day, right? Yeah.
Confucius wrote that, I think. But.
Right, way back when.
We appropriated it.
No, but it really was true. It's like, they came to Nick, we told them that we were a team, and that's yeah. how it was.
You know, people know you're a freelancer because you tell them you're a freelancer. They know that you're a freelancer because you have a portfolio that says you're a freelancer. So if you tell them something different, like, why wouldn't they expect that?
Yeah.
So we told them we were a team, and it worked.
Yeah,
so.
And that job went really well for us, and you know,
It's funny how simple it sounds now, but at the time it was like, oh, well, I guess we can do that now.
Yeah, exactly. And it wasn't something like the success of that, like we came out with a piece that we could both show as our own and something that we felt like let's keep this train rolling. It wasn't something where we're like, okay, now it's time to start a studio.
Right, now we got a little taste. We wanted a little bit more. It was
life.
A tasty
yeah.
taste. Yeah, it was a good taste.
We could.
Yeah, it was tasty.
How tasty was it?
It was pretty tasty.
Okay, it's pretty tasty.
Joke's over. But no, we got a taste of pulling bigger jobs, working together for the first time. It was really fun. It was really a good experience. And the client liked it. So why not keep that train rolling?
So over the next 2 years, we basically, any job that we thought could sustain both of us, we would pitch as a team. We'd, you know, come to Nick, come to me. We'd bring the other one in and say, this is what you're getting for that.
And this isn't every day. I mean, these opportunities, they were kind of sporadic, and you have to kind of gauge it. So if it looked bigger than it was for one person, we would say, okay, let's try it. Maybe we'll pitch as a team.
Right.
And this is mixed in between on-site work, too. I mean, we didn't.
Yeah, this was like, when it felt right, we would do it. So, out of context, that's terrible. So that would look like.
Oh, that would wait, look. Can you repeat that? No, I'm kidding.
So this is how that would look sometimes. Like, we would play with the wording a little bit. We would.
I really think the subtlety of how you talk about yourself makes a big difference. And in that first email, we said, we're this like ambiguous team. If you work with us, great. If not, like, that's a deal breaker. And here we're talking like. We use the term co-creative director. Maybe we're a director team. I don't know. Let them figure it out. But it kind of worked.
We play with this a lot.
Yeah, we kind of changed it up throughout the course of 2 years.
And it worked most of the time. But a lot of the time, clients would clients would basically be like, why? Like, we came to one of us. Like, there's suddenly two of you. Like,
so you have a job come to you. And all of a sudden, you're like, hey, here's my buddy Erik. We're a team. Like, yeah. No. Well, yeah. I just wanted it to you.
Yeah. So there was a lot of ambiguity about like what we were, and that was confusing. And
it wasn't always. It didn't always go as. And we knew this going in, and that wasn't always the case. But it definitely was a risk, and it was confusing for them. It wasn't the best for us.
Yeah. Here's an example of that, by the way. This is a response we got on one of those.
This is
exchanges.
An actual response. We're like screenshotting this stuff. This one's great.
So we
at
got
every line. they're question, they're doubting the process. So the first one, they're like, so is Nick part of the proposal or?
Yeah. And then how do you guys work together? And then the best, like we're trying to wrap our brain around what you guys are basically. And that was like,
I think I remember we lost this job too.
Yeah.
Which is pretty on point.
It didn't feel good. We were not feeling
good at all. For whatever reason.
We were just grasping a little bit, grasping a little more. Not
good.
Yeah,
we also felt like sheeps.
Yeah,
or wolves.
We felt like this, basically. We felt like what? Yeah. Like, it's not a good feeling. You need that initial trust when you're working with a client.
These are jobs we wanted, too.
Yeah.
So, it's not like we were just like, well, whatever, we'll just be a team. It's like, no, we wanted this.
Right, so... You know, you need that trust, and we were getting that kind of feedback every once in a while, and it just was not the best thing. So, that's us. And it led to the conclusion that we basically, we need to start something that's legitimate that we can put our own
brand on. So, over the course of the 2 years, we had been iterating and, like, are we a team? Are we a directing duo? Like, what is this? And we were spending way too much time writing emails. And at some point,
explaining what we were. It's like, well, it's not just me; it's Nick and I, and
it's
like
a huge pain in the ass.
Yeah, it was. So we, that led us to okay, we need to start this, and that was a big moment for us. Like,
it's like the most obvious thing, but
it really did.
So for us, starting a studio meant having a piece of how do we easily talk about something? Well, you start a studio,
right?
You have a thing that you can point to. And you can tell clients, here's what we're capable of. Here's, what we've done.
Yeah. Here's what, we're both committed to this.
It's clear, it's clear that we're just this one thing, and we're not, two people hanging out
for two different email address domains, weirdness going on.
And anyways.
So we started that, and we thought, all right, well, we had our business plan.
South Park, Underpants Gnomes. You get it.
Yeah.
You're fine.
So phase one for us was those, 2 years of basically testing things out. And now we were kind of in phase two trying to figure out.
We entered this mystery phase before profit happened. Then anyway, it's a GIF or picture.
Yeah, it's a picture.
It's a thing.
Naturally, what comes next? Our name. A lot of names.
This is page one of six.
Yeah.
If you've had a band, you know what it's like to figure out
These are embarrassing.
A name
Jesus
together.
Christ.
Tickle fight.
Yeah. Tickle fight. Yeah, tickle fight. Tickle. I actually was honestly a proponent of that. Okay. I'm kind of glad we didn't, though. There's some other good ones there. I'll let you find them later, but don't steal tickle fight. It's patent pending.
Yeah, trademarks on that one. So a lot of names thrown around. But really over those, those years that we were working together before it was official, we learned a lot of stuff,
This is really important, and this is for all you freelancers out there. For us to start a studio, we knew that we needed skills that we didn't have or didn't exercise very much, and the only way that we got those skills was doing direct client work. There's a lot of cool reasons to do on-site work. I was doing it during this time, but producing a job, managing your time, setting up a budget, subcontracting, hiring your friends, doing all that stuff, only came because we were doing direct client work.
Yeah.
And probably the most important part.
Yeah, I mean, we were working on projects that were our own, building that portfolio. So on day one, we could say this work, we own this work, this is ours, we can show this.
The only way we can really market ourselves is through what we've done. And the fact that we could show all that stuff and not get sued for it, try and show Marvel stuff and I'm going to get sued.
Yeah.
So
you just got sued.
I got sued. I think I just got sued just now.
Disney just came in the door.
I am so sorry. Retract. Is there a retraction?
Yeah, that's how it works.
Okay.
So with that, we launched. We decided to launch. We launched in April this year. It was a big moment for us.
I think it's funny. It's the strangest job change I've ever had. It felt really, honestly, for us, we built it up to this point where it was a moment where we were posting to Twitter, and in that moment, I felt like I changed jobs, and it was the most surreal thing, and no one gave a shit but us, and no one even knew, but we felt like the pressure was on, that meant that we couldn't work on site anymore. It meant that...
It meant all our old names and aliases and stuff. That was all behind us.
We aren't going to get work to our personal names as much as we were.
So
it was a lot of pressure for us. We felt it.
We felt it. And we, on that day, I think we fused. Yeah.
We had to show this.
This is actual footage.
I found this and...
It's the best gift of the whole... You guys can leave now. Just, like, that's... We, this is the best part.
You don't have to know what this is from to know... Yeah. Anyways, you're good.
One more?
Sure.
One more.
Is there one more?
Yeah, here we go.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, okay. So, we've launched. What's next? Naturally, a lot of questions. Our peers, clients, like...
So that was everything leading up to this point. And then we hit the button, we launched... And now we're a studio, so understandably, people had questions.
Right. They didn't... So like, are you still taking freelance work? What are you?
Yeah.
Like, are you guys taking stuff on the side as individuals? It's a very valid question.
We're one thing now. We're fine. We're one thing. We're not doing freelance work anymore.
Yeah. Oh my God, amazing question. Where's your office space?
Honestly, I would ask this too. If someone said, you have a studio, I'd go, where?
Right, yeah, very natural.
We have a very video game programmer mentality where it's get the first iteration out and then keep refining it. So studio space was not the first iteration. We'll talk about it more later, but.
Yeah, just making it, launching was that.
We don't work with clients much in person anyways, so for us it was whatever.
Yeah,
but
we're working on it.
Apparently it's something people think about.
Another thing.
Ugh.
Yeah, fuck that.
If you ever do social media, which maybe a couple of you do, I don't know.
Yeah.
We suck at this, personally. This is just stuff we're dealing with, guys. It's almost like getting the weight off our shoulders. But
yeah, it's like we've launched. We've got a new entity, right? We've got Run, Kick, Shout.
So I sucked at it. You sucked at it. But now we have a third thing that really probably is not good at it.
Yeah, we have a baby, and it needs its own Instagram.
Baby needs an Instagram. Baby needs a Twitter. Baby needs a Facebook. Baby just won't stop crying.
Yeah. Come on, baby.
Come on, baby.
We're working.
That's just something that we've been dealing with. And it's really important, though, because that's the main way we get work is through people... seeing us online. And
we're not denying the importance. We're just saying we're working on it.
Yeah. Stuff we're... Honestly, this is all about stuff we're going through.
Yeah. Lastly, we got some advice from a good friend, Danielle.
D.
She said, listen, you guys are launching. You need a press release. You need to launch this on the day you launch. You need to release this on the day you launch. And we said, oh, that's cool. What's a press release? We'd read about them. We knew they were in Stash and Motionographer.
Like that's something.
It's like
that's something big companies do, right?
Yeah, wow, the staff changes at the mill. Like that's Dick Tracy shit's going in.
Yeah,
there.
They're really invested into the inner workings of these studios.
Right.
But really, realized that no, probably someone at that studio wrote something about themselves and sent it to a site, and then they just posted it. So we did that.
Yeah.
And it's been super important. You can do that as a freelancer. You can write something about yourself and hope that somebody likes it.
Right. Yeah. I mean,
to us, that was like.
Yeah. So we sent that out to all the online publications we knew or researched. And we still get emails back from people that are like, hey, I read your thing. And
we can confirm that has led to work. That's been very helpful.
Yeah. Very helpful. So we just want to give a head nod to D. Get in the shot. Wait for it. No.
No,
still,
just
still.
Hit next. No? No?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you,
D.
Yes. So what's next for us? We're going to wrap this talk up. You guys can get a beer and say goodbye. We're thinking about reps a little bit.
I'm not sure if anyone has experienced reps. You can do this, honestly. I know individual freelancers who've done this, but for us... We've been talking about it. It's a good way to connect you with people you don't normally talk to. It's a good way to get your word out. But there's a lot of other things that go along with it. So something we're thinking about, something that's coming next.
Yeah,
wanted to let you know that's the thing that we're thinking about. And as a studio, it seems pretty important.
Right, yeah.
But honestly, 9 out of 10 stories are a shit show.
Yeah, finding the right person, the right rep is the
It's a whole other relationship you have to form.
And we're getting a space, finally.
We got a space. Next month, we're moving into a space. We heard the complaints. People can stop asking us. Like, yeah, we're getting a space. We know it's important.
Yeah. Details later. Feeling pretty good about it. Feeling real good about it.
That's probably some kind of an epic mountain range.
That's Chicago.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
It's a parking lot. That's a parking lot we filmed that in.
It's green screen. That's it, guys. Thank you so much for having us out.
That's our journey. That's what we're dealing with right now. Really appreciate it. Hit us up if you're a freelancer or a producer. We totally could use some help. Yeah.
Yeah, we're looking for good people out there. So come find us. We'll be drinking beers and wandering around.
Yeah. Thanks, guys.
Yeah. Thanks.
Thanks again for watching, everybody. A quick question of the day for you before we go. Put it down in the comments below. What would you call yourself? What's your title? What's on your business card? Are you a freelancer, a designer, a motion designer, an animator? Put it down in the comments. I'd love to see what everybody says down there. And also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel where we have plenty more videos just like this. And again, if you want to step up your motion design game this year, check out our new training page where we have hundreds of hours of motion design training ready for you to watch. All right, thanks again for watching, and I will see you in another video really soon. Bye, everybody.